It's Tri-State Live here at South by Southwest with Deadbeat Darling. They just finished up their set behind Hotel Vegas.
Yep.
And got in out of the dust in the AC, so they're chilling now. Why don't you guys just kind of pass the mic all the way down and give us what you do in the band and your name.
My name is Evan Howard. I play the drums.
My name is Mo. I play the guitar.
My name is Joseph, and I play my voice.
My name is Ian Everall, and I play the bass.
So, is this how many times have you guys played South by Southwest?
Deadbeat Darling, we've played South by Southwest as a band. This will be like I think our fourth time now, or third time actually. Personally, I lived here from '99 to 2005, so I've played South by Southwest every year since 1999, except for one. So it's been like what 10, 11 years now in a row. But this is the first time Ian's coming down and playing with us. He just joined the band. Today was his second show with us, which is kind of fantastic. This is our first experience all together here.
And so you guys are based in New York, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So how would you compare New York to Austin? It's like two major music centers in the country. Two words.
I mean, I'd say New York maybe thrives a little bit more off original music. I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, but most of the...
Well, that's just straight from the gut.
Well, I mean...
I think you're right, but...
I mean, if you go on Sixth Street on an average day, you're going to hear as much covers, I imagine, as you're going to hear. And I think New York has a... Just due to the fact that there's, however many times more people, you have an audience of a wider range of musical tastes. You can put a band together that's, I've seen a guitar player and a DJ with like effects, and there was like 50 people and they were really listening, free jazz, like probably don't get a real big audience for that down here, so.
Austin versus New York City.
Easy question.
Easy question. I was really fucked up when I lived here in Austin. Now that I'm in New York City, I'm less fucked up.
Oh,
no, I'm less. I'm way less fucked up than I was when I lived here. Yeah, no. Austin's fantastic, man. I mean, this is a great place to build a fan base. You can make a living in Austin, Texas, being a musician, man. There's no doubt about that, and I did that for a long time. You can also grow really old and wake up one day and be 42 and be playing the same residency at the same club you were playing when you were 28, which is what you have to avoid, which is why I moved to New York City, because there ain't no way New York City's letting you do that. I made my living here in Austin playing every Monday night at Momo's solo acoustic. I put the whole night together and I made $600 a night. You can live off $600 a week in Austin, Texas. Easy. Easy peasy.
Beer is cheap.
Beer is cheap. Drugs are cheap. Women.
Expensive.
Very, very, very tasteful and exquisite. In Austin, Texas. Now, I love Austin. I miss it here. I still consider it my home. But sometimes you gotta kick yourself out of the nest, if you will.
So what do you guys have on tap next after South by for Deadbeat Darling?
We're actually just about to record our next record in London. We just signed a deal with a new record label, and we're gonna be
talk about.
Yeah, quiet.
We're going to be working with Ken Nelson, producer who's worked with band Gomez and Badly Drawn Boy and Kings of Convenience and the first three Coldplay records.
Yeah.
I guess, aka the good ones, maybe. Something like that. I've heard people say that. I don't know the other ones, but so we're really excited. So we're going to be, probably the first time all of us have really had the chance to record in a proper style, not 2 days to do a record, but maybe a month and a half. So. We're all really excited about it if we don't kill each other before we get there.
We're gonna head out there at some point next 3 weeks to a month in April, and I think we'll be out there for a little bit, but it'll be cool. It'll be nice to be for all of us to be, out of our element here, out of our comfort zone, if you will, and into like a new comfort zone, new experience, and just be sort of holed up. I mean, if we don't kill ourselves before this, we're going to kill ourselves there, together.
Absolutely. The thing about it is, though, is we're not sure, but it looks like they're going to put us in this, there's like some old school famous recording studio in the mountains of Wales. So we're going to be out in the Welsh mountains. It's going to be misty sunrises over like rolling green meadows with sheep. I just asked the record label. I was like, okay, that's awesome. That sounds fantastic. But are there women out there too? And there was dead silence.
There's sheep.
So I'll make tea for you in the morning. And then right.
You make tea for me, and then I'll just go out and hang out with the sheep. Yeah. I'll come back. I'll be relaxed and ready to rock it.
Well, is there anything else you guys want to share with the Tri-State Indie?
No, man.
I just want to say thanks for the key to the city. Austin was really kind. Check this key out.
Yeah, look at that.
Yeah, get this key in here. Thanks. That's good.
Wait, I got a key.
It's fucking solid.
I got a key that looks kind of like
amazing.
That, dude.
Thank you guys for having us on. I know you guys are obviously from the Tri-State area. So Friday, March, I don't know when this is going to air, but Friday, March 25th, we're playing Cameo Gallery in Williamsburg. That's our next and our last New York City show before we move to London to make this record. So if you guys are around, please come out. Cameo Gallery is a fantastic venue. We play about 10 p.m. And it's a great lineup of bands playing all night. So yeah, we'll hopefully see you there, you know?
Thanks a lot, Deadbeat Darling.
Thanks for having us.
Good luck in London. Good luck the rest of the week.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Anytime.
Thank you, guys.
Tri-State Indie over and out.